What is up, my friends? Christina back here with another video. This is Enjoy Your Carry, and I am here to talk about carry. It is Friday. I normally do a video on Saturdays and Wednesdays, but tomorrow I foresee difficulty getting a video out, so I'm shooting this out there for today, Friday, a little early. This is the Wandered Tech Pouch. This is the large version. They do have a medium and small. I opted for the large so that I could just get the most use out of it. This, I believe, is around 3 liters in size. I got the bone off-white beige type color. I wanted something lighter on the outside because the interior colors mirror the exterior. And so if I'd gotten the black bag, the entire inside would be black, and y'all know how much I hate an all-black interior. Real quick on the outside, we have 2 loops here that can help you when opening and closing the zippers. 2 compartments, AquaGuard water sealed, nice big pulls that came on the zippers. 2 grab handles on either side. Attachment points here for either a sling strap or to attach the bag to a Wandered backpack. And that was kind of how it was intended to go. And then there was a strap on the bottom to help you hold it when you are opening and closing the zippers to access the inside. Let us get straight into it, and then I'll tell you what I like and don't like towards the end. The front compartment is 100% lined with this soft, fleecy, felty material. Perfect for a phone, or something like that that's, you need to be protected. Maybe a battery bank, maybe a hard drive, but I personally used it for my phone. Fits in here perfectly. This is a 14 Pro Max case. Something to note as well, if you look over here, there's a little red tab. This is to mark for you where the pass-through is. There is a cord pass-through here that you can charge your phone while it's here, run the charging cable through to the other side and plug it into a portable battery if you are so inclined to do that. I never actually utilize that, but it is there if you need it. Main compartment, same deal with the zipper. And here's the inside. As you can see, there is a lot of space and you have that same color as the exterior in the interior. On this side, you have 2 nice-sized mesh compartments on that wall. You can fit a small wallet, you can fit a hard drive, potentially you can fit a battery bank. Anything like that could go in either of these. The other wall, there is a pen loop right there at the top. And then there are 3 mesh compartments. This one, similar size as to the ones over here. The other 2 are much more narrow. So I left these items in to kind of show you. Here is, there's a, my Palmer's lip balm, and you could probably fit another lipstick right next to it. And that's about it. You're not gonna fit the same, anything with that's wide. I wanna say it's about 2 inches or so. It's not very wide. This phone obviously wouldn't fit here, but I'm just showing you this for the width. So you can see the width of this middle pocket. This one over here, same thing. Here's my Leatherman Wave. It just fits in here nicely, but that's about the width of the pocket. So I don't exactly know what they intended these little pockets for, but just to note, they are there and they are useful, but they are more narrow. So you have to sort of be a little bit more deliberate about what you're putting there. Main capacity of the bag is nice and spacious. You know, there's a lot you could put in here. I fit a couple of pouches in here when I use this as an EDC sling. I had some tissues. I threw my keys in there. A tiny first aid thing, my insurance card pouch. I mean, it fits a good amount. I can't complain when it comes to the capacity. Again, I use this more as a sling than I did a tech pouch. And so if you use it for just tech and strictly like put it inside of a larger bag, I think you similarly would have a good experience. What else? So on the back, you have these attachment points. Now, I did not buy the optional strap that Wandered makes, but I noticed that the attachment is the same. It's the gatekeeper, which is the same as the alpaca strap. So I just kind of was using my alpaca strap with this bag. So I would put it on. I found it to work better. Again, with these gatekeepers, like of all. Okay, I found it to work better here as opposed to here. This I felt was more to when you're attaching the bag to a backpack. And then the other one, let me just show you, goes right there. Okay, now as you can see, obviously, these straps are right sort of halfway down the bag, you know, height-wise. They're not really, they're angled ever so slightly, but like, long story short, you guys, this is definitely a pouch first and a sling second, as opposed to sling first, pouch second. Now, I think the medium size might work a little bit better as a sling, but I thought the medium would be too small. I'd actually like to get my hands on that to compare, but I will tell you that wearing this was not my favorite. Just the way it sits on the body, it was not as great of an experience as like another, you know, true sling. It did work. It was not uncomfortable, but I didn't love the fit or just the way it laid on me quite as much. And I think you can see what I mean in terms of the way the strap attaches to the bag. If it was a little bit wider in this area, or if the attachment points were even a little bit higher, I don't know, I feel like it might lay better, you know, across the body. But it is what it is. Again, this is, in my opinion, definitely a pouch first and a sling second. But you know, sometimes it's good to have that. It's good to have a pouch that you can use, that you can then put it in your backpack when you travel perhaps, and when you get to your destination, you know, you whip out the strap and all of a sudden this becomes your EDC bag, you know, for when you're on the go, wherever you are. And that works. One thing I will say is that I really, really, really got a little frustrated with there only being one zipper. And to some, this may be like no big deal, but I would have loved if there were two zippers on each compartment. I kept forgetting like where the zipper was, and I would often be like fumbling, looking for the zipper. I love to sort of keep my zips in the middle. And so for both compartments, I would have really appreciated there to be two zippers. Some people might find that to be too much and a little bit excessive, or even, what's the word I'm trying to think of? Just not as streamlined or not as sleek as it could be. I personally would have preferred it. I really found myself just often wanting to pull from here, and the zipper wasn't here, it was here. So anyway, that's just my personal preference. And also, like, even though there's nice grab handles on the sides, I just wish there was something right here to grab. I would have loved like a little handle here as well. Again, I get why it's not there. But just for me personally, when I was testing this, that's what I found myself wanting. I just wanted two zips on each compartment, and I wanted to grab something right here. But there are many out there who probably will disagree with me. And so that's just my opinion. And also you'll notice like it looks a little wonky when you're looking at, I don't know, like, you see how it almost looks like it's more squeezed on this end than this end? I don't think, at first I thought it was like a defect in the bag, but it really doesn't appear to be at all. It just, you know, when the package came to me, I guess it sort of, it was squished a little bit more on this side. And because this never was packed to the max, it never sort of fixed itself. So like it was always looking that way, like not even, not symmetrical. And again, like, this is really like a nitpick, but it's just something to note. Like, the material kind of, once it's squeezed for a little bit, it sort of stays that way. It doesn't want to go back. I played with it a bit, like trying to stretch it, and it never really got to like that perfect place. I suppose if I had stuffed more in here to stretch it out perhaps a little bit, it would have done what I was trying to get it to do, but it never really did. All in all, I think this might be one that I move on from. You know, I already have a tech pouch that I am happy with in terms of, you know, keeping my all my stuff located in terms of the Peak Design tech pouch. I don't see myself moving away from that one into this one. And I don't love this as a sling enough to keep it for that purpose. But yeah, I do appreciate the lighter color inside. I do like the design of the compartments in terms of the way it's laid out. I found this very useful for my phone. But again, I wanted that second zip on this compartment, and for a sling, it just wasn't great for me. So yeah, let me know what you guys think. Have you guys tried out this tech pouch? Have you tried the medium? And how was that experience for you? Let me know, because I think I may have chosen the wrong one. Maybe I should have gone with the medium. Let me know, guys. Let me know in the comments. Any questions as well, put them there. I will link this down below. There's lots of colors. There's like a purple, an orange, a green, a yellow, I think. I mean, Wandered's sort of gotten better in terms of the colorways, in my opinion. It's not a home run, in my opinion. But again, let me know what you guys think. Also, feel free to email me, enjoyyourcarry@gmail.com. If you guys have any questions, or even if you have any interest in purchasing any of the bags that I reviewed, I do often sell them in order to, you know, get more bags for the channel. And so if you have any interest in this or any of the other ones that you may have seen, if I'm not using them still, they may be available for sale. So hit me up, let me know. Thank you guys so much. I appreciate the support. I will see you guys next week, probably Wednesday, to get a new video out to you guys. Thanks so much. See you in the next one.